Today I want to show you the way that I create my Semcolder-like zoom transitions in DaVinci Resolve, and I promise you it's going to be that simple. Everybody can follow along no matter the skill set. Now first up, we need an adjustment clip, and if you don't know where to find that, come over to the top left of your screen to where it says effects, then go down to where it says effects once again, and there you should see the adjustment clip. Now if the adjustment clip or any other effect is something that you often use, you can simply highlight the star right here to the right and it will appear down there in your favorites tab, which is super handy because now you can just drag and drop it from there without having to go to the effects menu and search for the different effects that you use on a regular basis. So now the length of the adjustment clip will determine the final length of the transition. And by default, the adjustment clip is 5 seconds long, which is way too long for this type of transition. So I'm gonna keep it to 1 second, which is what I always use. So come over to the start of the adjustment clip right here, hold the shift key on your keyboard, press the arrow key to the right to jump forward exactly 1 second in time. Then what you want to do, you can either shrink this down to the playhead or use your keyboard shortcut to make a cut and delete the end. And once you've done that, you want to place the adjustment clip right over where the cut is gonna happen, with equal frames on the left side as you have on the right side. Now with that being done, hover your playhead over the adjustment clip and jump over into the Fusion page down here. And now all we need to do is add a transform node, and we can simply do that by highlighting our media in one node. Either you're gonna grab it from the toolbar up here, this is the transform node, or you can hit shift spacebar and type in XF and now add the transform node from there, which should automatically be connected in between. However, if it isn't, and if it's somewhere in the free space, you can hold the shift key, left click, and drag it over the line, and once the line changes color, you can let go of the click and it's been connected. Now with the transform node selected, we want to come over to the first frame of the animation. Then we want to jump into the inspector in the top right corner and set a keyframe on size. Now let me quickly make this a single viewer window. Then we want to move forward in our timeline to the last frame of the first clip, which in this case is frame 11. Set another keyframe on size, then you want to move forward exactly one frame, which should be the first frame of the second clip, and set another keyframe on size, and then move forward to the end of the timeline and create another keyframe on size. So once you've set your 4 keyframes, on frame 0 we don't want to change any settings. However, on frame 11 is where we want to be zoomed in already. So on frame 11, which is the last frame of the first clip, I'm going to zoom in and scale this up to around 1.5, 1.6, roughly something like that. Now we want to hop over to frame 12, and because we don't want to lose resolution, we have to start zoomed out here. So let's go to around 0.75. Now right now you should see a blank canvas behind your footage appear, and you can easily fix that by going down to where it says edges and change that to duplicate. And now we want to move over to frame 23, and there the size should be already keyframed at 1 because we've done that prior to. Right now we can see that our transition is happening, however it's pretty slow and very linear, and we want to make that smooth and a little bit faster. So we're going to open up the spline window in the top right corner of our screen, and we're going to extend this just a little bit, select the transform tool and select the zoom to fit button up here. Then we want to highlight all of our 4 keyframes and hit S on the keyboard. With the second keyframe right here, we want to grab the left handle and drag it down all the way like that. And now on the third keyframe, we want to grab the right handle and just drag that up to something like that. And this should do the trick to make the transition pretty seamless. All right, that looks pretty good to me. However, we're missing a little bit of motion blur, and we can easily fix that by going to our transform node, come up to where it says settings, and there you can see motion blur. Just activate that, crank up the quality to get a better quality motion blur, and you can leave the shutter angle at 180 degrees, or if it's a little bit too little for you, you can crank up the shutter angle to around 220 degrees, and that will do the trick of getting you a little bit more motion blur. So if you're happy with this, you can call it a day right here, but there's one more thing that we can add to spice up this transition, and that is by adding a little bit of lens distortion. So we're gonna hit shift spacebar with the transform node selected and type in lens, and then just add the lens distortion node. With the lens distortion node, we want to come over to frame 0, so set a keyframe on distortion in the inspector and just type in 0. Then we want to come to the middle where the cut's gonna happen, and we're gonna crank up the distortion 2 around, let's go with 2.5, and then come over to frame 23, the last frame of our animation, and set down the distortion back to 0. Now let's open up the spline window once again and smoothen out the lens distortion. So what you can do is click the three dots up here, select show only selected tool. Now we want to select all the keyframes once again and just hit S on our keyboard, and we can drag in those lower handles just like so, and now drag in the right handle just like so. And this will do the trick of making this transition even more powerful. So now you have a pretty smooth zoom in transition. So let's say you're happy with the transition and you want to store it so you can reuse it in all projects. All we got to do is come up to your media pool in the top left corner, click the three dots right here, and select show power bins. Now the power bin section appears, and under master you can create a new folder, and in here you can just grab the adjustment clip, drag it in here, and now gonna rename that to zoom in. And once you have the transition stored in your power bin section, you can always just grab it from there so you can reuse it in as many projects and as often as you'd like without having to recreate it over and over again. However, one thing that you have to keep in mind, you have to align this transition perfectly in order for the keyframes that we've set in the Fusion page to make sense. Now I'll show you what that looks like if the keyframes are aligned perfectly. However, if the keyframes are off by a couple frames, it will look like this. Everybody can tell that this doesn't look right, so we have to align it perfectly. We're gonna move over three frames, and now everything is aligned, everything makes sense. So let's say you wanna use a zoom in transition. And I'm gonna bring this up because I've seen a lot of people on social media mess this up. When you apply a zoom in transition, make sure the shot that you transition from is a wide shot, and the shot that you transition to is a tight shot, as seen in this example right here, because otherwise it won't make sense. So let me just switch them around real quick. So right now we're going from a tight shot to a wide shot with a zoom in transition. And in my opinion, this just doesn't look right. And how to create a zoom out transition to transition from a tight shot to a wide shot is what I'm gonna show you right now. So we're gonna reuse this zoom in transition, come over into the Fusion page. So first of all, I'm gonna add another transform node, and the same principles apply. So we're gonna go to the first frame of the animation, create a keyframe on size, then we're gonna move forward to the last frame of the first shot. Again, create another keyframe, move over one frame to the first frame of the second shot, create another keyframe, and then we wanna move to the end, frame 23, and create another keyframe. So because we wanna zoom out of the scene, on frame 0, we don't wanna change any parameters. So now let's go to our second keyframe, which is on frame 11 right here, and there we wanna zoom out. So reduce the size to around 0.75 and change the edge behavior from canvas to duplicate. Then move over to frame 12, and here we want to start zoomed in. Let's up the size a little bit, like 1.5, and then come over to the end, and it should be at 1. So now let's take a look what the transition actually looks like. Again, that's pretty rough. However, we're gonna refine that by using our spline tool. So let's open up the spline window once again, select size, hit the zoom to fit button, highlight all of those keyframes, hit S on our keyboard, and right now we wanna change this a little bit differently. Here on the second keyframe, we wanna grab this left handle and just drag it up like so. Up on the third keyframe, we wanna grab this right handle and just drag it down all the way, not that much, like that. And if we have a look right now, this is what the zoom out transition looks like. It's pretty good. However, again, there's motion blur missing, but we're gonna fix that in the transform node by going over to settings, activate motion blur, crank up the quality, and increase the shutter angle to 220 degrees, and this is what the transition looks like. So we're transitioning out from a tight shot to a wide shot. And now you can store this transition the exact same way. Just grab this right here and drag it in, and now the highlighted one, we're just gonna change the name to zoom out, and that's it. Now you have two transitions ready to go to reuse in every project. It's all just drag and drop. Hope this video was helpful to you. Hope you like it. Hope you enjoyed it. If so, please consider leaving a like. Otherwise, I'm gonna hope you have an amazing day, and I'm gonna see you next week. Bye.